Well, hello everyone, I'm Yanni from BeauView Gaming, and today we are gonna play some Brightpaw. So this is a puzzle adventure game that was released in September of last year, and in this one we're gonna be playing as Theo, the house cat that wakes up to find his owners having been murdered. And then we are gonna be exploring the house and trying to figure out what happened. I think it is more a puzzle game than anything else, so it's like escape room puzzles where you have to try and make it through each room, but we're gonna see, from what I understand, there's about 70 levels or so there's actually a lot. It does say continue here, but I only just started up the game, so it's not because I played it before. There's a level select, as you can see here right now. It only shows the first one because I haven't started yet. And there are apparently also skins that you can collect. I didn't know about that. So there is apparently 27 that we can unlock by completing various hidden tasks. Okay. I know there are collectibles. There's actually a lot. I think it said over 180 or something on the Steam store page. And that kind of makes sense when you see this, right? There's 22, 24, 21. We just try and click on one, research all manner of bizarre experiments and projects. Okay, so I have no idea what we have to look out for, but I guess we'll figure out when we play, right? A whole bunch of stuff there, and settings-wise, you can choose between different languages. Let's see, there's English, Italian, Spanish, German, French, Portuguese and English. I'm just gonna stick with this. You can turn subtitles on and off. There's assist mode. I'm not quite sure what that is about, but I guess it's to make the puzzles easier, maybe. Gonna leave the rumble on, but I might turn it off. We're gonna see how much it actually affects things, because I don't always like it if it's a lot of screen shaking or something. Then of course there's some graphic settings. There's volume settings, and there's also privacy, where you can choose to turn this on and off, on or off, depending on if you want to agree to some analytics. There's accessibility options, which is really nice. So there's subtitles, you can change the size. Oh, I must have clicked this by accident. It's actually medium by default, so I'm gonna leave it on medium, and then I'll see if I wanna change it. Subtitles, you can change the color. There's also a colorblind mode even that you can turn on, so that is really nice. So yep, that was that. Let's just get going. Of course, there's an about section as well, where you can see some stuff about the or the credits and some stuff about the developer and publisher. So anyway, let's just jump into this. Okay, so Act Zero, Level 1, Shelter.
Oh, there you are, Theo. Honestly, let your own dream. Do you even know where you are? Ah, well, it's time we got you sorted out with these cards. Come on now, we haven't got all day.
Okay, so tap and hold a card to preview and release to play it. Okay. Okay, so if I do this, then I can see how we walk.
Oh,
and
sorry about that. Just give that rewind button a tap and we'll see if we can't start walking around things instead of into them.
Okay, that would be this one, yes.
If you ever find yourself in a pickle, just remember that you can take a step back and try something else.
Ah, yeah, so
now, give these a whirl and see where they get you.
Okay, so now we have multiple cards. I guess this one maybe resets the entire level, potentially. And then, of course, we can pause things as well. Okay. Yeah, so we can. So it's gonna be a lot of this. Like, eventually, we're gonna be failing probably because there's gonna be different dangers, and we're probably gonna end up dying or something. But then you can rewind and try and see if you can do things better, right? I do see a whole bunch of kitties here. Oh, I guess it's when they decided to get Theo, right? So this is kind of like the animal shelter. Okay, so I think I would like to go like this, and can I like rotate the screen or something? It's really hard to see what's going on here, but I guess let's go forward, and then I think maybe we can turn around the corner here. Aha, click and drag to rotate the camera and use the scroll wheel to zoom in and out. Okay. Ah, okay, so no Q and E, just click and drag. Nice. There's also this down here. I don't know what that does, though. It looks a little bit like a camera and a puzzle piece. But clicking on it doesn't seem to really do anything. And okay, so then we can zoom out. We can zoom in. Awesome. So now what? Because I didn't quite make it over to them, did I? So oh, and there was also the collectibles we have to look out for. I have no idea what we're gonna need to look for. Okay, so maybe this is not what we needed to do. Okay. Okay.
There you go.
There. Okay.
Remember, Theo, you can look around at any time.
Yeah. I had to kind of get that to progress to be able to do anything else. Okay. Tap on a highlighted object to view a collectible. Oh, this. I would never have noticed that. Okay. Odd cat box. A strangely familiar but otherwise nondescript box washed up on the shores of Theo's subconscious. Ew. Okay, there's only one collectible in here, apparently.
I wonder what that's doing sitting around here. Maybe you should keep your eyes open for other interesting things. You never know what you'll find.
That's true.
Well, we're done here. Go on, leap into your family's arms. Lauren and Nathaniel are waiting.
Aww. Okay, so it might be easier to kind of turn it around like this so you have it facing the way the cats go, right? So I think we're gonna go like this. Uh-huh. And then do-do-do. Here we go. Act 1 Murder. Okay, so that was kind of the little tutorial thing. I missed there was a little tip pop-up with something with L and something. But I guess we'll figure it all out, right? Act 1, Level 1, Waking Up. Oh dear.
Ah! What was that? Oh, okay. Well, after being woken unceremoniously by a sudden noise, our hero Theo felt that if he was to be kept awake, he deserved to know why.
Very true. Very true. Okay, so we're gonna want to go to the door, but there might be some other things here that we can do something. Let's see. Oh, this is, yeah, this is blinking. So, oh, that's how it is with collectibles. Okay, Theo's bed, warm, comforting, and tempting, a reminder of hazy dreams. Ew, okay, but there should be 3 collectibles here, so is there anything else?
Although Theo felt the lure of sleep and the comfort of his bed, he really should go and investigate this ruckus.
Oh, yep, this little, yep, there we go, Nathaniel's recognition. It is always a cause for celebration when genius is recognized. Okay, so there should be one more. I think that it's always based on a single room, potentially. So I just have to find something else that is kind of blinking, maybe? It only kind of does it a little bit, or maybe it's when you mouse over it, I don't know. None of this looks like something
it
we can.
It was a lovely office, to be sure. But no questions were being answered, just staying where he was.
You are being a little annoying. When they have, like, collectibles. Oh, here we go, it's just hard to see. So it's only when you mouse over it, it seems that it will kind of blink. Joshua's acceptance letter. An acceptance letter for tutelage, or however you pronounce that. What does that mean? Tutelage. Okay, so he's a tutor or something? At a prestigious school. Perhaps proof that genius is hereditary. Okay, so found all 3. Let's move forward then. Act 1, Level 2, Disturbance. Ooh, okay.
Hearing the yelling from the kitchen, Theo wondered if he had really moved from his bed just to listen to some tiff.
Okay, so I definitely see some things blink. Okay, so it blinks right when the level starts. Oh, it still blinks. Ha 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 ha. So it's not only just when you mouse over it. Family photo. Despite the awkward posing, happiness and pride are visible in this photo. Huh? And I saw this. Ooh. Hastily packed suitcase, a suitcase rapidly filled and suddenly cast aside.
Despite his efforts, Theo couldn't simply stay here forever. He had to find out what was happening.
Oh, I hope he's not going to do that the entire game, because it's kind of a bad fit if they have all the collectibles that you are supposed to find in each level, right? And then at the same time, he complains every time you stick around for more than 10 seconds. Anyway, Grand Piano no longer attended to or cared for, but Grand despite the lack of use. Okay, so found all three here. Now I just need to make it to the door. So we can go one way or the other way around. It doesn't really seem to matter, does it? So let's just take this one and this one. There's still a lot of noise. Screaming.
Ah, perhaps things were a little more serious than he thought.
Yeah. Ooh, bodies. This is getting bad now, I think.
The kitchen seemed normal. Except, what was that? He could see across the room.
Oh no.
He had to take a closer look.
Oh no. Okay. Okay, Joshua's travels, a selfie taken by Joshua during his travels after college, sent to his parents as a memento. You okay? It's kind of hard to see anything over here. Anything blinking in this area? Okay, there's something over here. Joshua and Theo, a young boy and his cat. Whoever said dogs are man's best friend had clearly never seen this photo, or maybe they never had a cat. Because cats can be the same thing for sure. Let's see. Let's see anything else. Oh, here we go. Theo's football, one of Theo's most prized possessions, completely devoid of answers, inside, or food. Well, there is something here, but that doesn't look very edible. Okay, let's see if we can actually get over here, right? So, have a little look-see. That one would not work. We can go here, there. Okay, let's try this one. Then we end up there, and then we would like to go straight and turn right.
God! Theo couldn't believe what he was seeing. His family, motionless on the floor. But that was it. No gun? Nothing at all? Was someone else here?
Oh! Rewind. This one.
As he turned away, Theo could only think about one thing. Someone was surely responsible for this, and he had to know who.
Oh dear. Look at that. That is not good. Okay, so it has kind of specific settings when you're zooming. So you can be all the way out, or it can be like here, or you can zoom all the way in. There's no like, you can't completely control it yourself.
Although things looked bleak, Theo had to press on. Yes. He had to.
Yes, yes, yes. Okay, so there we go. Act 1, level 4, light.
Cautiously examining the hallway, Theo saw no signs of the killer. Instead, he found a path of destruction carved through strange machines before him.
Very odd indeed. Okay, well, here we go. Nathaniel's graduation. The optimism of youth, oblivious to the crushing disappointment of reality after formal education. Yeah, I'm sure some of us have realized or had that experience, right? Okay, I think this was one. A grandfather clock. Like all household clocks, the rhythmic ticking is a constant reminder of the universe's slow march to entropy. And then there was, oh no, it's this one. Out of place, a robot, a strange robot sitting in the front room and falling to pieces. This kind of strange little robot. Okay. Okay, so we need to get over there. Let's turn around like this so we can take, I think, this one.
The deeper into the room Theo moved, the more he realized that something was amiss. That bright red light hadn't always been there, had it?
Ah, so this light over here, right? Okay. Well, nothing we can do but keep going. Ooh, achievement unlocked. Act 1, murder. So we completed Act 1 and we are on to Act 2. Lasers. Ooh, that doesn't sound good.
Although he could not shake the image of his departed owners, Theo suddenly found himself somewhere very different indeed. However, before he could appreciate his new surroundings, he found his attention drawn to the glowing hot wall of energy in front of him.
Okay. Let's have a little look at the setting. Oh, no, okay. So how do you... Oh, I was kind of curious about those... Okay, if we click here... Oh, that's interesting. That's a different way of looking at it. So that's how you can use it. So you kind of have it like this. And then you can look at these to try and figure it out. Okay, let's go back to this view. So depending on what you prefer, this might be easier than having this kind of, I guess, it's an isometric ISO look or ISO angle or whatever it is it's called. There's some ISO games that has this like angle you always see things at, right? But anyway, let's see. I do see some stuff blinking, so let's start with that. Ruined security bot, a modern and threatening looking robot rendered immobile and useless. Ew, okay. I thought I saw two things blinking, but apparently there's only one. Okay, but the lasers are there all the time, so how am I supposed to get past them? Doesn't seem like there's anything I can... Okay. I guess we're just gonna try and go straight.
Faced something so clearly hazardous, he thought it might be wise to take a moment to think before diving headlong into oblivion.
Well, that's probably a good idea. Let's wait. Aha! Let's move.
Oh, what a pleasant surprise. After his daring maneuver, Theo found that he was still alive. Unfortunately, there was one more laser to slip past.
Yeah. Okay, so we can go one, two, then we end up there. Okay, we're gonna need this one, right? One... then we go one, two, here, here. Okay, what if we wait again? And then we use this one.
Theo glared at the broken robot blocking his path. After risking his life twice, he was in no mood for this obstruction. Perhaps that broken vent offered salvation.
That could be a good deal for a little kitty, right? Act 2, level 2, janitor. Mm-hmm.
Still somewhat tense from his previous trial, Theo was immensely relieved to find no deadly lasers when he emerged from the vent. Oh. On the other hand, he was instead faced with a functional, frantic, and quite soggy security robot.
Uh-huh. Okay. I don't know why it suddenly kind of turned like that. What's up with this plant over here? That's kind of funny. When you click on it. Oh, maybe there's stuff you can interact with like that. That's kind of funny. Okay. But we need to find something blinking. What's blinking around here? Oh, this is blinking. Okay, so there's three collectibles. Sea mine advertisement. Need to safeguard your underwater assets. These marvels in explosive technology will quickly demonstrate the meaning of private property. Ew. Yeah, okay, it seems like his parents have been much into some kind of security business or something, right? Janitor. Okay, a comfortable flatfish. A fish who goes by the name Fergus, whose steely gaze wards off even the hungriest of felines. Ooh. Well, if they have an aquarium like this and all this stuff, they definitely seem like people who have made a good deal of money, right? Can I see anything else blinking somewhere? Oh, this, haha, janitorial bot, a poor custodian spinning their wheels attempting to clean up after someone else. Look at this guy. Love it. Love it, love it, love it. Okay, so we need to try and get out of here. So we could go here and kind of go... We're definitely gonna need over here, we're gonna need to go like this, and then we're gonna need to be able to turn. Let's see. This is the only one where we can kind of turn this way, right? And then we're probably gonna need this to turn and go that way. But I don't feel like we can go far enough. So maybe. Oh. Okay, well, we can always rewind, right?
By the distracted machine, Theo found himself eyeing the hole riddled aquarium. Either someone was stalking the hall, shooting at water features, or the security needed to work on their aim.
Oh, yeah. Oh, it's because he's trying to sort out all the water. Look at that. That's actually a pretty clever robot, right? He's even trying to clear out all the water here. I wonder what these little yellow markers mean. Does that mean I can actually go over there or what? Okay, so. What if we use this one to get to here? And this one.
Though the appeal of fresh fish was enticing, it was offset by the risk of an unexpected bath. Rather than contemplate such a terrible fate any further, Theo decided to make a quick exit.
There we go. Okay. Yes. Stealth. Okay, let's see.
Advancing cautiously, Theo was encouraged by the sight of another aquarium, this time with the water safely inside, not threatening to unpleasantly dampen his fur. There was no time to fish, however, as security appeared to be taking its job a touch more seriously.
Okay. Okay, so we have a kitty, golden cat statue, an overt but befitting show of respect to the true superior life on Earth. Indeed. I'm sure my Maxi would agree with that for sure.
Although Theo could be easily distracted, he knew when it was time to focus.
Okay, starfish. Alive? Not sure. Dead? Maybe. Unfazed by the current situation? Definitely. I do really like the humor of the game, and I do like the narrator. If he just didn't quite try to hurry us along constantly, that's a little bit annoying. Handgun advertisement, reliable, concealable, and effective. A must-have sidearm for the professional hench person. It comes with a variety of upgrades to fit your style and needs. Ooh, fancy. Okay.
That time had arrived.
Yep. Okay, so this robot, I don't think we want to get close to that. Let's see, how can we go?
That time had arrived.
Yeah. See, that's what I mean. It's kind of a bit annoying. Okay, so I think he's gonna go around this way. So depending on when I click. So if I click now, he will go this way, right? If I click now, he will go that way, so.
Tearing his attention away from the unattainable, Theo delicately stepped between the broken remains of some very expensive-looking showpieces. Despite his lack of any understanding of fine art, he was disgusted by the wanton destruction before him.
I don't know if we have to use all the casts.
Having successfully weaved past the searching eyes of the guard, he was overjoyed to see that he could just follow the killer through a door, instead of crawling through the ventilation like a rodent.
Okay, so we don't have to get them to match completely. I was kind of curious if you had like four left,
Theo,
if you had to have,
eyes about the have a car with four. Room, the impressive decor marred by the smoking wreckage of robotic guards. Clearly, someone with no respect for interior design had been this way. However, hanging over the remains of a reception desk, Theo spotted something that took his interest. Bright Paw Industries.
Ooh, look at this guy. Aww, looking so sad. Okay, let's see. Vending machine. Offers a variety of villainous beverages. Unfortunately not designed to be used by felines. Ew. Okay. See if we can find anything else. Oh, it kind of marks where it walks, I guess. So you'll
Although
walk here.
This place was impressive. Theo knew he had precious little time to admire it.
Where's there something else that's blinking? Blinking. Oh, we can't rustle with this.
The Theo leaves. Had many questions, but lollygagging wouldn't answer any of them.
Hmm. Okay, what is... I can't see anything blinking here.
Theo was rendered immobile for a moment in amazement of his...
Okay, this one. Reception bot. Though this robot can't stop panicking, it refuses to abandon its position at the reception desk. That's dedication. Oh, look at that. Look at that little face there.
Surroundings.
Looks so cute. Okay, need to find... I almost didn't see that it was blinking because its face is already doing something. Let's see. What might... Okay, this guy, no. We need one more thing, right? Out of the bed, though, I can't see anything. Nothing in there. It's none of this. There's also this item here. Nope. Wow. Okay. I feel like I'm completely blind. Okay, now I found all the collectibles so far, so now I'm kind of stubborn. I want to find the rest of them. Bright paw. Ooh, okay. Bright paw sign. A proud and majestic company sign out of place amongst the debris. I don't see that blinking at all, but maybe it was. Okay. Well, anyway. This little dude is gonna move this way, so maybe we don't even have to go through here. But we do have a wait option. But maybe we can walk around him. Well, if we use this, then 1, 2, 3, then we end up in his path. So I think we're gonna start with one of these. He's gonna move. Then we have 1, 2, 3. Then we end up in the laser. That's not good. Okay, what if we use one more of these?
Despite the damage, the underlying class of this Brightpaw establishment was clear. The placement of several large aquariums, brimming with exotic fish, was an inspired design choice that Theo could respect.
Okay, so now we are over here.
Theo crossed the room, breathing in the intoxicating fragrance of fish, while taking care to avoid the remaining hazards.
Oh, I messed up.
As he did, his mind began to wander. Why was a place like this situated beneath his home? And more importantly, why had these fishy treats not been brought to his attention before?
Yeah, I wonder why. Okay, level 5, show floor. Ew, look at this place.
At first glance, it appeared that Theo had stumbled into a storage room for broken glass. Except there were other items in the glittering fragments. Grenades? Missiles? An umbrella?
Okay.
Putting the U into eugenics.
Okay. Let's see, show floor, yes, patrol robot, a security robot overly focused on its patrol route. The biggest threat is accidentally being run over. Okay, so far the puzzles are not really that hard, especially since you can rewind, but I suspect it's gonna get trickier as we get further into the game. Okay, classic bomb. When it comes down to it, sometimes bad guys just want the classics. Okay, need to find one more. Yeah, you're not blinking, it's just this light on the face that makes it seem like it, right? Where's the umbrella that he was talking about? Oh, it's in here. But nope, can't click on that. Oh, this one, haha. Trick umbrella advertisement. Rain or shine, this is simply the first choice in defense and offense. This undercover weapon will turn heads or remove them. And is suitable for formal events. Ew. Okay, so now we have this little robot, which will go over here, right? Should we try and see if we can do it this? Definitely want to wait for you to move. That might be the only time we want to know, because he should move the second I move. So it's very turn-based, right? So if I go Oh, it's like waiting a turn, right? So if I wait a turn, he's gonna move. But I can't really get all the way out of the way, can I? Let's see. This one, 1, 2. Go left, that's not gonna work. We can go here, that's not gonna work. We can go 1, 2 here again for that one. Then we have this one. 1, 2, 3. Then we can go left or right. Which kind of feels like... Well, we kind of have to start by waiting, don't we? And let him move. Right, and then if I move, but then if I use this, then I end up there, and then he's just gonna come back. So how is that gonna help? How? Can I? Okay, so what if I use this one? Then we end up here, and then he moves over there, right? But then we can't really get... Then we are going to be facing that way. That's not going to work. Okay, the only two options I can see we have right here is this or this. But I feel like if we use any of them, we are going to get caught. Okay, let's see what happens if we get caught by the rope. See, like that. Oh, pain cry. Oh, no. Oh, I got my first achievement. Roadkill. Ouch. Oh, no, it's achievement progress. So you're actually supposed to get killed 10 times to get that achievement. Ouch. Okay. Rewind. But if I say wait, then he's gonna move over there. Oh, he goes all the way around. Ooh, okay. Oh, I got a new card. Instead. I didn't expect to get a new card, but that's good. Let's follow him.
Theo padded behind the guard, pondering his discoveries. A hidden underground facility, robotic security, and now rooms filled with odd weapons. What on earth was this place? Looking back, Theo considered that it was perhaps unwise to leave such destructive toys lying around. On the other hand, there was no way someone would leave live explosives on display. Probably best to ignore it and hurry on.
Yeah, we didn't have this card to start with, did we? I don't think we did. So, okay, so it seems like you get a new card when you use one of those weight cards. I didn't quite expect that, but that's cool.
Theo contemplated the ruins of the once magnificent boardroom, which had been reduced to little more than burnt mahogany by some kind of explosion. Apparently, the killer had needed to clear the room in a hurry. But why?
Good question.
Oh, perhaps those lasers were a motivator.
Grenade advertisement and need your enemies to disappear in a hurry? Would you prefer them to be in pieces? Then these are definitely for you. Caution, good throwing arm not included. Okay, we have boardroom. Oh no, Nathaniel's dealings. What Nathaniel might foolishly consider his first real success in life, sealed by a handshake and immortalized in print. Huh. These guys don't really seem like someone I would want to get into business with, honestly. Okay. Let's see. Then we had this. A trapped chair. These chairs are designed to help establish dominance in a meeting by disposing of undesirable attendees. Oh. By disposing of... okay. Not sure I want to know what they do. Okay, so we need to get over here. Ah, okay, because we have a door over there. Yes. Aha. This might actually be the easier way to do this. So, let's see. This can bring us right or left. There's not really anything to keep us or protect or...
With the wall of death slowly advancing, Theo scrambled for a plan to slip by. There, across the room, a shattered glass wall offering a glimpse of escape.
How are we supposed to get there before that reaches us? Okay. Let's see. So we can go straight, then we end up here, or we can go straight and turn right. But then we don't have an option for turning left, so I don't think we really want to go up here, do we? Okay, if we go here, and then we can go here and turn here. But then we can't get all the way in here, so we're gonna need a wait. How do I know when to wait? Where can we hide from this? Don't really... It won't just go all the way across the room? How do I know where I can hide from it? Well, it's gonna hit this, right? Then we have this. How can we hide from the lace? I'm not quite sure I understand that, but okay. I guess we're just gonna try and do this. Unless it turns around and goes back again.
Deftly avoiding glass with his paws, Theo found his eyes drawn to a large portrait on the wall.
Oh!
Was that Nathaniel? As he stood, he wondered, how much of all this was his master responsible for?
Ah, that's this he's talking about, right? Okay, so see, now we're safe, so we can actually... we have to land on that. Okay, yes. I was already thinking about moving to the right. Okay, we completed Act 2. Yay! Okay, so that is it for this time, guys. We're gonna continue with this next time. I'm kind of liking this. So far, it's not too tricky to figure out, but we'll see how it goes. We're not that many levels in yet. Still a long way to go to around 70, right? So, thank you for watching. And as always, do take care and happy gaming!